Hey friend, welcome back to the Sage Audio Channel. Today we'll be answering the question, what is in the pocket for music? So stick around for the full video, but first, if this is a topic that you find interesting, I'd highly recommend looking into the blog post that's associated with this video. You can find the link for that in the description box below. Also, if you're an artist, engineer, or producer, and you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample of it. All you have to do is set up the short account, upload the song, and we do the rest. So it isn't uncommon to hear a music term and wonder what it means exactly. Becoming well-versed in music means understanding its discourse, which can certainly be easier said than done. Now with that in mind, understanding what in the pocket means can be important when talking to musicians or trying to understand your music better. In short, being in the pocket really means being in tempo and following the groove of the instrumentation with which you're performing. Now when creating music, each production process, be it tracking, editing, mixing, or mastering, plays a specific role in establishing a sense of music being in the pocket. With that said, we'll cover how each of these steps affects the timing of music and results in a finalized and in-time sounding record. So first, let's look at how to create an in-the-pocket performance during tracking. Now, the easiest way to establish an in-the-pocket performance during recording or tracking is by using a metronome. Using a metronome and recording the drums first is often the best and go-to method for creating an in-the-pocket foundation for your recording. When beginning to record a song, one mistake that often gets made is recording the guitar or piano first. Now, although this can have good results, it can easily cause the recording to be out of the pocket once more instruments are recorded. With that said, drums and bass are often the first instruments to be recorded. More times than not, these instruments are recorded to a metronome or a click track. Now, if the drummer or the bassist gets off tempo or plays the wrong part, their performance will be punched in. Punched in means that the engineer will let the drummer or whoever hear the recording for a few bars and then click record at the exact moment that the performance needs to be remedied. So for example, if the drummer dropped his drumstick right before the chorus began, instead of creating an entirely new recording, the engineer would start playback a couple bars before the chorus and then hit record right when the chorus began, in turn recording the new performance while keeping what was good about the original performance. Now this process will be repeated for all instruments until only the best, most in-time takes are recorded. Now having a well-rehearsed band or group and an engineer that knows when to stop a recording and punch in results in a in-the-pocket performance. Now if both the artist and the engineers are talented enough, it's entirely possible that editing won't be needed to create a in-the-pocket sound. However, this isn't always the case, and editing is often used after tracking to create a more in-time recording. So next, let's look at how to create an in-the-pocket performance during editing. Now, the majority of work needed to create an in-the-pocket recording is often accomplished during the editing stage, as this provides the best opportunity to isolate and move various aspects of an audio recording. Editing can be a time-consuming process, but it's really necessary for making music in the pocket. Now, there are a few ways an in-the-pocket sound is established during editing. The first is by reviewing and choosing the best performances available. Now, depending on the session, this can take a fair amount of time or nearly no time at all. If a huge amount of takes were recorded and each one only takes up a small portion of the full performance needed for a complete sounded recording, then this stage can definitely be time consuming. Now, regardless, finding the performances that best suit a particular project is an important step in establishing an in-time performance. The next way that editing accounts for the timing of a performance is by manually isolating percussive elements like kick or snare hits, and then repositioning them to be more in time. When doing so, the correct BPM and grid settings should be in place to make this process as easy as possible. The same process is often used for correcting the timing of vocals, bass guitars, and other organic audio tracks, or in other words, tracks that were not created using a software instrument or MIDI data. Lastly, editing can correct the timing of a performance using a process known as quantization. This form of quantization shouldn't be confused with the quantization that occurs during A to D conversion, as they are regarding two very different things. Now, quantization as it relates to editing and time correction is the process of a computer determining the current position of a sample and then moving it to the nearest timestamp. This timestamp can be a bar, a beat, division, or tick, depending on the quantization settings of the device used for this quantization. Now, quantization is typically performed on MIDI data and allows for a relatively easy way to accomplish an in-the-pocket sound for a recording. Now, in addition to these three methods, a fourth and less used method is also an option. This method is known as flex and is accomplished by stretching or compressing a section of audio with pitch shifting. Now, when using flex mode, the pitch will be increased to speed up a sample or decreased to slow it down. Now, as you can imagine, editing in flex mode creates unwanted artifacts as well as noticeable pitch shifting if the sample is greatly off time. Now, for these reasons, using the first three methods detailed for creating an in-the-time performance during editing are more often used than the other methods, whereas flex should only be used sparingly. Lastly, let's look at how to create an in-the-pocket performance during mixing and mastering. Now, various forms of processing can be used during mixing to establish an in-the-pocket performance and to accentuate in-time elements of that mix. During mixing, setting the correct times for compressors as well as temporal processors helps to establish an in-the-pocket sound. A similar situation can be said of mastering in that the settings of various processors, primarily compressors, will affect the timing of a recording. So let's look at some compressor settings, mainly the release setting, to better understand this. The release setting is typically displayed in milliseconds and can be set to be in time with the tempo of your track. Now, although many compressors have an auto function that can complete this timing for you, you might still need to do some simple math for certain plugins. Now, if you need to do this, simply divide 60,000 by your BPM and you'll get the correct time for a quarter note. You can then divide this number or multiply it to create, say, eighth notes, half notes, or whatever you want. Now, these same calculations can be applied to reverb times, delay times, and any setting that is time-based. So these are some of our thoughts on creating an in-the-pocket recording, but what do you think? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Also, definitely check out the blog post where you can find a lot more information on this topic and others like it. The link is in the description box below. Also, if you're an artist or an engineer, send us one of your mixes at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. All you have to do is set up the short account, upload the song, and we'll do the rest. But thank you so much for watching. We really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like and share this video with your friends. This way, we know if you'd like to see more videos like this one. Also, you can subscribe to the channel. We release new videos every week, and subscribing is the best way to stay up to date. There's a comment section where you can leave your thoughts on this video or a suggestion for a future video. And again, if you're an artist or an engineer and you have a mix that you need mastered, send it to us at sageaudio.com. We'll master it for you and send you a free mastered sample. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.